25-year-old Maddie moved from Sydney to Melbourne earlier this year, but struggled to find somewhere to live.
We had good applications, we had great references, we could not figure out why we kept getting rejected.
Eventually, Maddie and her two housemates received a call offering them this apartment in Melbourne's southeast.
We had only gotten a virtual inspection from the property manager because she cancelled our two in-person inspections.
As soon as they moved in, they knew something wasn't right.
Well, there was a bit of an odour, and at first I didn't really think too much of it.
Oh my God.
Then they discovered the cause of the smell.
So when we looked at the cupboards, there was paper attached to the back of the cupboards. It had been covered up. You could just tell that was mould. And then when we looked at the ceiling, it had looked like there'd been paint over it, and the paint had started to peel off with more mould.
They moved out immediately.
We basically just said, we were like, we're not staying in here. This is ridiculous. We just hadn't even moved all of her stuff in.
What does it feel like when you are there?
It feels dirty.
Mould can cause anything from asthma attacks to rashes, so Maddie and her housemates approached Rodney Morley Real Estate with their concerns.
They gaslit us. They said, no, like, you don't know what you're talking about.
The tenants arranged for an independent mould assessment, which the agency tried to block. The findings were damning.
It's riddled through the entire apartment. There was mould on the windowsills, mould in the air conditioning, mould everywhere.
Which rooms or areas are affected? And he had said all rooms. All rooms?
Yeah.
Every single one.
Mm-hmm.
And the real estate agent's saying there's no mould.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We had tried to basically say to them, hey, the easiest way out of this is to give us our money back and we're going, like, see you later. And they were like, no, you're not going to get your money back.
Undaunted, they took the dispute to the Victorian Civil and Administrative Tribunal.
I remember the real estate agent just said, a story like this is going to take about 6 months to get a hearing, probably not going to be successful, so there's no point. And I said, watch me. After our first VCAT hearing, the magistrate ordered the real estate agent to make sure that we get our bond back. And then after the second VCAT trial, that was when she had put her foot down and said, no, 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 these tenants, they should never have paid rent in the first place because this place is unlivable.
By this stage, the trio had spent about $6,000, which they didn't get back from their agent for more than a month.
It has been so stressful. My hair's fallen out. I think I lost about 6 kilos because I just couldn't eat. This real estate agent would have walked over anyone that didn't speak up about their concerns.
The row over the mouldy apartment is now before Consumer Affairs Victoria. As for Maddie and her friends, they had to go house hunting all over again.
I went to an inspection and there was over like 40, 50 people there. There was lines all the way out on the block.
Finally, they found somewhere to live, but Maddie hasn't given up the fight.
As a real estate agent, you need to ensure that the property is livable. We felt so blindsided and that place should never have been leased in the first place.
What a horrible story.
Mm-hmm. It's shocking. Yeah. I mean, I interviewed a young mum only a couple of weeks ago on this show, and two of the bedrooms in her 5-bedroom home were completely uninhabitable because of mould. Mm-hmm. But she doesn't have the resources to fight it, so she just has to live there.
It just makes you wonder how many other people are out there like that who don't have the wherewithal, not just the resources, but just the gumption to do it.
All the time.
You can read the statement from Rodney Morley Real Estate on our website if you'd like it.